Hey there, it's Kaylee. This video is on adding and subtracting money. Are you ready? Let's get started. Have you already learned how to add and subtract with decimals? Then I have good news for you. Adding and subtracting money is the exact same thing. Remember from the lessons on counting money, whenever our coins, or the numbers after the decimal, add up to 100, we've earned another dollar. So here, the hundredth place, we store our pennies and nickels. And here in the tenths place, we store our dimes and quarters. And in the ones place, we store our $1 and $5 bills. And in the tens place, we store our $10, $20, and $50 bills. Let's do some examples of adding and subtracting money together. So here our problem says, how much is 34 cents plus $2.62? So we have 0.34 cents plus $2.62. I can add my dollar signs in here. So now I'm just adding like normal decimals. So 4 plus 2, I have 6. 6 plus 3 gives me 9. I move my decimal point down, and then 2 plus $0 is $2. So my total would come to $2.96, which is right there. Nice work. Let's try a subtraction one. So this time my question says, how much is $9.21 minus $4.75? So I'll write $9.21 minus $4.75. So remember, when we subtract money, it's just like subtracting a normal decimal problem. So I have 1 minus 5, that's not going to work. I'm going to have to borrow. So I take 1 away from there. I add my 10 here. So I have 11 minus 5 is 6. But now I have 1 minus 7, so I need to borrow again. If I go over to my ones place, this is going to turn into an 8. I'm taking it 10 over here, so now I have 11 minus 7, which comes to 4. I bring my decimal straight down, and I have $8 minus $4, which leaves me $4. I bring down my unit sign, and my total comes to $4.46, which is right there. So great job, and now you get to practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.